get wet. The chest! Hand it over!
You have a debt to pay. You've been captain of the Black Pearl for 13 years. That was our agreement.
Master Tana,
feel free to go ashore. The better next time we make port.
You know I've David Jones, yes? A man and a sea. A great sailor. Until he ran afoul of that which vexed all men. See, it was a woman as changing and harsh and untamable as the sea. He never stopped loving her. But the pain it caused him was too much to live with. But not enough to cause him to die. It was not worth feeling what small, fleeting joy like brings. And so, he carved out him out, lock it away in a chest, and hide the chest from the world.
10 years I devoted to the duty you charged me. 10 years I looked after those who died. See, and finally, when we could be together again, you weren't there. The Dutchman sails as its captain commands,
and its captain is to sail it as commanded.
Hello everybody, welcome back to SNJ Gamers here. Today, I bring you another video of Sea of Thieves. Today is a very special video. I've gotten some requests on my last video, which I made by customizing Jack Sparrow and created a tutorial on how to make him yourself, and I created another video on how to make Captain Barbossa, you know, his first mate from Pirates of the Caribbean movies. And so those videos have been doing pretty well, and they've gotten some attention, and I've gotten a few requests on create another character. He's no ordinary pirate, he's a legend himself. And if you know anything about Pirates of the Caribbean, you'll know a sailor called Davy Jones. Guy's awesome, he's a legend. Idea of his look. I had a little bit of just like, I pulled up a picture, but I had no help of like how to make him in Sea of Thieves. I had no sort of assistance through another video or anything. I looked at just a picture of him, and I really went from there and just off of the image in my mind. The captain of the Flying Dutchman. You're about to see him. So to create your own Davy Jones, you're gonna want to find your it spawns you at a random outpost. Whenever you come out of the tavern, whichever outpost you're on, you're going to want to come up and find this clothes store, this apparel. It has this little boot. You find the boot and you see it, you know you're in the right place. So you're going to go inside.
Got a problem.
Talk to Cooper, whatever his name is. So, this is as close as I could possibly get him. I mean, I really poured some effort into this one. I really did. There's no, unfortunately, there's no tentacles or anything like that, that I'm aware of. I've really gone through every single piece of this, every little item, every little detail, as close as I could possibly get it. And other than curses, there might be a curse to get tentacles or anything like he has, but as of my knowing, there's nothing like that. So this look is 100% purchasable. This is, you can buy this straight off the bat without having to have any curses or anything, or breaking any curses or anything, without having to put any effort in whatsoever, except for needing, of course, money. This is in-game money. So the first thing you want to do is you're going to come in here. Now, for your hats, you have a couple different options. So, first one, not using the top bumper triggers. Don't use those. Just use the D-pad and scroll on down, over and down, to the Ocean Crawler hat. This is one of the options. It's not the one I'm currently using, but it looks pretty good. Now, you have other options, such as the Explorer's hat, which is kind of similar. It'll run you a little bit cheaper, but these are about, this one's about 8,000, if I'm not mistaken. This one's around the same, about 2,000. Now, the one I chose was the Fearless Bone Crusher hat, because it has, like, the bones on it, which kind of reminded me of, like, the barnacles and the seaweed and the coral that Davy Jones has on his hat, because he's gone underwater, and as he's, you know, done the duty that is charged by Calypso, if you know the story and everything, all that canon and everything about it, then you'll know, like, that over time he's become a monster, as he's called, and he's really become more a part of the sea. All the fish and the crab arm and everything, I've really gone into detail with that as much as I can to get it as close as I possibly can. Now, you have other options for your hat. The Deep Ocean Crawler hat, which is way more expensive. And then, if you have unlocked it, the Azure Ocean Crawler hat, which I have not unlocked. It requires the Hunter of Trophy Fish accommodation. But it looks pretty good because it's blue just like Davy Jones' hat. It's kind of a bluish purple. But for this one, if you're going to make it the look that I have, you're going to want to go with your Fearless Bone Crusher hat.
Don't come back.
Wow, that was
what
rude.
What are you looking at?
Is that a joke because you have one eye? That guy was rude. The other shopkeeper had was like, my heart sings in your presence. This guy's just a jerk. Next, you're going to want to use your bumpers and scroll to the right. Use your D-pad and come over to either the Grand Admiral belt, because you're going to use a buckle, big buckle. But you can use any of them that you really want to. You can use the Ocean Crawler if you felt like it, but it's kind of a smaller belt. Or you could use the Kraken belt because, you know, it's his pet, so it kind of is fitting. But for the actual, like, accurate look to it, you're going to want to use your Sea Dog belt. That's the one I have equipped right now. But you do have other options. If you wanted to, you could use the huge, the double belt, or where's the other one? It's called the huge belt. Anyways, it's in there. But if you felt like doing it, then you could use that one. Next, you're going to go over here to your beard. Now, this is where it's important, because you have a couple different options, but if you want to get as close as you possibly can to Davy Jones, then you're going to want to use the Bilge Rat Beard, because it'll give you the mustache that hangs down and the beard. You could also use the Rotten Bilge Rat, but it doesn't have the mustache. See, it's missing that important mustache, because, you know, he has the two really long mustache tentacles that hang down real low, the longest ones he has. And if you wanted to, you could also use the Ruffin. I'm sorry if I'm saying that incorrectly. I'm just trying to say it as best as I can. And I'm sorry if I'm stuttering. I'm going to try my best. But this is another option you can use. But see, hold on, that's not the right one. There you go. See, it does pretty good, but this one, in my opinion, gets you, like, the really round dreads, almost like tentacles, as close as you possibly can. It gets you as close as you possibly can to having the tentacles. Now for boots, this one, if you followed and watched my Jack Sparrow tutorial, You have a couple options. You can really choose any boots you feel like. It's really up to you. But if you're going to go for my look, following this tutorial, you're going to want to use the cuffed high boots, just like the ones for Jack Sparrow. Next, you're going to scroll past the eye patch and dress. You're going to want to go to your gloves. Now, this one doesn't really matter, but if you're going to go with the one I have, you're going to scroll over, and you have so many different options. You can go with the fingerless glove. You can, not that one. That one I used for Jack Sparrow, my mistake. I went with the gloves of the Wailing Barnacle because Davy Jones is underwater, so he has like barnacles and everything on him, and that's the closest thing you can get to it. So use gloves of the Wailing Barnacle. It's going to cost you about 15 doubloons, so make sure that you have plenty of gold in this one and plenty of doubloons, because overall this costs you... It's been a whole day since yesterday. I'm trying to remember how much it cost me. I had about 90,000, and I scored a huge win the other day. And I also traded in doubloons for some gold. Let's get me back up there a little bit. Not sure if the exchange rate amounts were even fair, but it got me back up there. So it brought me down, I want to say about 30 grand. So make sure that you have like 30,000, 25 to 30,000 coin and about 100 doubloons to spare, just to fluctuate and have options available, because you don't want to buy something and be like, oops, now I can't have the complete look that I wanted because I spent it on an accidental item. Or you want to have options. You want to have some cushion money that you can use to buy different items. Now for your hair, this one I bought before and I was like, oh, I was going to use it for Jack Sparrow because I didn't see the dreads. This one comes into play so perfectly because Davy Jones, he wears like a bandana underneath his hat, but without the hair, then he has like less tentacles, so the beard really makes up for it. So use the Majestic Silverine hat. Hair creates the more tentacle vibe with it. It gives you that extra look to it. Rides those extra tentacles that run all the way up his face, because you know it's not just on his chin. It's all the way from the sides of his head by his ears all the way down to his mid-chest. Now this doesn't come to you about his mid-chest, but it gets you as close as you possibly can. And if you've seen the scene from the third Pirates of the Caribbean at World's End, when he goes and sees Calypso, and she touches him, and it turns him back to what he first looked like, that's also what I'm going off of. Now for hooks, you do have plenty of options here, but since he has the crab hand, use the Ocean Crawler hook. It's the cheapest one, and it's the most accurate, in my opinion. Now let me show you some of the other options you have. You can use... not that one. Where is it? The Azure Ocean Crawler hook. But overall, you're going to want to use an Ocean Crawler hook. You can use a Deep Ocean Crawler hook, but look, it's 36,450 coins. I don't think you really want to spend that kind of money on just one item. And it's red and purple. Although this one is kind of light blue and gold, but it gets you as close as you really can. I know I'm saying that a lot. As close as you really can. There's no perfect Davy Jones look in this, but I'm gonna get you there as much as I can. Now for your coat, you're going to scroll over. You can use the Admiral jacket, or you can use the Castaway Bilge Rat jacket, but see, Davy Jones jacket kind of comes down. It's kind of a long trench coat. So I wouldn't recommend that one. I would recommend using the Ocean Crawler jacket, which is what I have, and it gives that kind of crustacean kind of crab look and has like the barnacles kind of look to it, like you've been underwater, and it gives him that kind of seaweed and all the little details from the ocean. So that's the one I would use. Now you do have other options like the deep ocean crawler jacket, but as you, the more you scroll to the right, the more expensive it's going to be, like this one. Renegade Sea Dog jacket. I'm not saying it's good for Davy Jones, but it's almost $100,000. I would not spend that kind of coin if I didn't have to. You could use the Azure Ocean Crawler jacket if you felt like it. Let me get to it. It's just not displaying. Come on. I don't know why it's not doing it. There we go. See, it looks pretty good. But for the one I'm going for, I'm going to make it as least costly as possible. Use the Ocean Crawler jacket. It looks good, and it fits the right colors, and it looks good. Peg? Yep, he's got a peg. This one he's got a peg. You can use any one you want, but I would not really recommend this. Kind of like a crab leg. It just doesn't really look good. It kind of looks wonky and like a, almost like a saw blade. It just doesn't really look it. You know, you would really want it to be kind of like a spike, almost, like an actual crab leg. But this one just looks like a crab, like one of the claws. So it just doesn't really fit well, in my opinion. It can, if it works for you, go for it. Get it. Because it's only $8,100. Sailor peg leg, it's a cheap option. It looks good. You can do the Sea Dog peg leg if you wanted to. I would use it for Captain Barbossa. That's what I originally bought it for. You could do the Bone Crusher peg leg, which I have unlocked. But this one over here, I spent a little, some dabloons on it, I believe, or a little extra coin to get it. And it's the Fearless Bone Crusher peg leg, which kind of gives it that bone, barnacle, coral kind of look to it with the seaweed and all that, you know, the sea life, you know, because Davy Jones has become one with the sea. But the one that I'm using right now is Peg Leg of the Wailing Barnacle, and it's going to cost you a couple doubloons, but it's totally worth it because it has the barnacles on it and it does not look bad. So I would use that.
Get out of my sights.
You've got to be kidding me. Oh my goodness. Okay, just a reminder, if you are, even if you are in a shop, you have to still be, you still have to exit out every once in a while and then go back in, because if you act, your character is holding still, regardless of if you're moving around in the menus, it'll kick you and say you're idle. So yeah, I should have remembered that, because I ran into that problem last night and I found a way to resolve it, but just by backing out and moving side to side, moving around a little bit, and then going back in. And it saves you a lot of time if you do that. I'm sorry for the wait. There we go. Try and get us back in as quick as possible. This is what he's going to end up looking like in the end, by the way. So if you're still interested at this point, stick around. I'm not done yet. There's a lot more that goes into it. I promise you, I'm so sorry that you're having to wait and for this inconvenience, this slip up. I'm trying not to stutter. I'm trying not to repeat myself too many times. I'm trying to make precise and to the point. So, I'm not going to keep talking about Pirates of the Caribbean. I'm just going to, not going into detail so much. I'm just going to really give you straightforward the tutorial from this point out. I know some of you might be like, man, just get on with it. Just stop talking about Pirates of the Caribbean. We know that's the reason we're here. I'm going to get straight to the point now. I have yet to actually go to one of these skeleton forts and check it out for myself. Because I've gone to skeleton forts prior to this point, but they've been completely empty. They're a good place to pick up gunpowder kegs if you didn't know that. Gunpowder kegs, you know, they're not really worth much, but they do come in handy, and you can sell them. Okay, so we're on the same island. Yes, we are. Good. All right, we're back. Galleon, come on up here. The shop with the boot. I mean, look at the shadow. Like, the shadow even looks cool. I can't really even see it. I'll show you in a better spot. Get to the point.
Want something?
Yes. I want you to not kick me out of your shop. Okay. The boots, by the way, it doesn't matter which pair you pick, and whatever peg you pick, it's going to put it on the correct side, so you don't have to worry about that. You're like, what happens if it's not on the right side? You know, it is Davy Jones. He has a peg, and it is on his right, so it does that by default. So that is really awesome. I don't know how to switch legs with it. I don't know if you can, but it does put it naturally on the correct side. So that happens to match up perfectly. Now the peg leg I am using, I've already stated this, is the peg leg of the Wailing Barnacle. That one matches up perfectly. Now your shirt, you can't really see it because of the jacket, but if you do want to take off your jacket, use the Castaway Bilge Rat shirt. It's not too expensive, and it looks pretty good. I haven't really taken off the jacket to see, but you can skip this step if you want. This is where you have more options, just like every category, but there are some options that line up better than others. Your Admiral trousers? Not really. You're not really hitting it. You're not going to want to do any really long pants, unless you feel like it, of course. This is completely how you want to do it. I'm not saying there's any right or wrong, but if you want to make it look like me, then just follow along and don't choose any long pants, unless that's what you want. You can buy the Bilge Rat trousers, which are fairly inexpensive, and they look good because they match up on that side, but see, they leave your knee exposed, so I kind of decided against it. The Hunter trousers, they work just fine with about every outfit, depending on what you're looking for. I used them on Jack Sparrow and Barbossa. For this one, you're going to want to use the Ocean Crawler trousers, because that one kind of gives you the tattered and ripped, like, falling apart old pants kind of look, with like the ripped and torn fabric. If I can get it to load. There we go. So see, it fits perfectly in that little slot right there, and it has the barnacles on the edge of it. But you can also go with the trousers of the Wailing Barnacle. Now you're like, wow, there's a lot of trouser, you know, Wailing Barnacle accessories here. And honestly, that is fitting for most of his look. You can use the Fearless Bone Crusher trousers, which gives it that kind of wrap on that side, which looks pretty good. But for the one that I'm using the trousers of the Wailing Barnacle. So you can buy whichever one you want. They're going to cost a little coin and doubloons. And the Deep Ocean trouser. Ocean Crawler trousers are more expensive, but they can work. So if you choose, if you're like, hey, I kind of want the more dark look with it, then you can go for that. But for pants, use the Wailing Barnacle. Tattoos, I don't know of Davy Jones having any tattoos, but I did add in some details, which you already have. It's already in the chest, so you don't have to buy anything with that. But for hook, use the Ocean Crawler hook. Or whichever hook you want to do, I use the Ocean Crawler
hook. Don't come back!
I really don't like this guy, he's kind of a jerk. So when you come outside, this is where all your clothes are going to be. And this is where your hooks, your pegs, and all your accessories, tattoos, hair dye and all that. Your beard, everything's right in there. So I'm going to equip everything. So this is what you look like in the end. This is what it boils down to. It looks pretty good. In my opinion, it looks pretty dang good. So I'm gonna take everything off. Including on this one. Completely bald and pretty much nude all the way down except for the underwear. Thank goodness we don't need to censor anything. So now I'm going to just show you that I literally have nothing on. We're going to start completely from scratch. So first things first, whichever way you want to start with clothing, start with the accessories. You can go into here. Now you're going to want to go over past costumes, because I don't have anything in that. I'm not sure about you, if you do or not. But here's all your options, because you can't equip like a bandana with a hat. At least I haven't figured that out, because they're separate items, so they only equips one item per part of your body. Gloves are going to be for both hands, unless you have a hook. That hook's not going to go to both sides, or a specific side of your preference. It'll just go to whichever side that it's supposed to. Your hat, you can't wear more than one. So, and you can't wear it with a bandana. Makes sense, you only have one head, not hair. I don't know why I'm having such a hard time talking, I'm so sorry. Okay. You can use your ocean crawler hat, your explorer's hat, or your fearless bone crusher hat. I equipped that one. Looks like Davy Jones already, starting to look like him already. Now this is what it'll look like. You're like, kind of looks like a chick's outfit. Now, that might be true, but you can go with it. It doesn't really matter. Because once you put on the jacket, this one right here, the ocean crawler jacket, it's going to cover it up anyways. So you really don't have to buy this shirt. And I would recommend, if you're short on coin, don't go the extra step. Just save your coin. You can use it on other things. And to just have it. So once you equip your ocean crawler jacket, you're golden. Go back over to your gloves. Equip the gloves of Wailing Barnacle. And unfortunately, he doesn't have the tentacle hands. I couldn't find anything like that, but I found something as close as I could get it, with the barnacles being like underwater sea life. So, pass the dress, go over to the belt, equip the sea dog belt. Looking good. Go over to barnacles. Tartar sauce. Go over here to your bottoms. And that's when you can equip your ocean crawler trousers, your whatever pants you chose, Bilgerat, trousers of the Wailing Barnacle, or fearless bone crusher trousers. Get that. Go over to your boots. Now you have options here. Majestic Souverain boots, weather-worn boots, like in my other tutorials, but use cuffed high boots. But you're like, now he has 2 feet and doesn't have the peg. Just having a peg will only replace one boot with a peg. It won't unequip boots. You don't have to buy a specific one boot for whatever leg. It'll just replace it for you. So no worries there. Underwear, your choice. You have to wear them. Yep. I don't know how long it's been since they've changed them, if ever. I'm just kidding. Now, go over here to this chest. This is where you're going to have all your facial features and your facial hair, the hair on top of your head, the colors and all that. Just to make sure I'm not becoming idle. Go over to your beard. This is where it comes important. Either Ruffin Sea Dog Beard or your Bilgerat Beard. That's the one I went with originally, is the Bilgerat Beard. It's not the right color, but I'm getting to that. Now on top. This is where you go over here. It just looks like his hair is all over the place. Almost like tentacles. Click it. Majestic Silverine hair. Now you can go over to your hair dye. This is where it gets real important. Because you don't want it to... Unless you do. If you want it to be bone white, go for it. If you want it to be shadow black, go for it. Whatever color you feel like it should be for you. This is completely up to you. But I already bought mine, and it's the golden one. It's the blonde. Not golden blonde, but it's blonde. Now let me show you which one it is. Where'd it go? Right in here. It is not that one. We're getting too far away. Is it pale blonde? Yes. It's pale blonde hair. That's the one. Because it's going to get you to that kind of like tan blonde tentacle look to it on his face. That's the closest color you can get. It matches perfectly in my opinion. He doesn't have any eye patches unless you want him to. Then you can add it. Your peg. Now you have your sailor peg. Your sea dog peg. Or your peg leg of the Wailing Barnacle. Or your Fearless Bone Crusher peg leg. Ignore this one. These three options, 1, 2, 3, A, B, and C, are your best options. Let me show you what this one looks like. See, looks pretty good. Now with this peg leg, let me show you what that one looks like. And now, let me show you this one. Just the regular sailor peg leg. There you go. That's how it's done. There you are. Now, I'm not sure if Davy Jones is completely bald underneath, but I haven't seen him having any hair. All hair that he has been replaced by tentacles. So, going over here with this hair, boom, the beard. Boom there. Looking pretty dang good. So for peg, the one that I used was Peg Leg of the Wailing Barnacle. Title, whatever you choose. Tattoos, I added something kind of funny, which was the, you know how he's like with the key for his chest with his heart in it? Let me see where it's at. Is that one? Be great if he would stop rotating. I chose that one. I think it was that one. Now, you can't really control him spinning right now, because he just continues to do it. You can't really control that. Let me just see if I get the right one. You could do that one. Or you could do this one. I'm not sure which Roman numerals those are at the moment. If I saw it and looked it up and remembered, then I would remember. I only remember like up to really like here and here. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Yeah, X is 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. And then this is another one, Shroud Breaker. You could do any tattoo set you want. But for me, I chose to do the 14th one. Is it 14th or 13th? 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 or 15th. I think it was this one. I think it was the 14th set. So use tattoo set 14. Even though you cannot see it at all, it's still just a detail there. If you wanted to go into every single detail. Curses, got none, emotes, whichever ones you have, default or not. Make sure I have everything there. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the captain of the Flying Dutchman, Davy Jones. Now, if you would like to see other videos on how to customize other characters, please let me know down in the comments below. Smash the like button, please. Subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you thought of this tutorial, if you'd make any changes, have any more requests, want me to do ship customizations, because I have a couple ideas for the Black Pearl, Davy Jones, Flying Dutchman, really any of that sort of thing. I'll come up with it and customize it and create a video for it. See, I really had no intention on creating Davy Jones, but as soon as I got a request, I was like, that sounds like a really great idea. In day one with this, I fought a ship and won. I found a sunken, must have been a galleon or a brig that had despawned because the Reaper's chest had moved. It wasn't doing like the little lights into the sky. And so I was like, that's weird, but I tracked it because it's like a little beacon. You can track it on the map, and I followed it. And it was really high up in the sky, and it just was froze there from where the ship had been. And there was just so much loot. I raked in over like 30 grand worth of loot. Both doubloons, there was at least like 9 gems. Like gems of all different kinds. There was at least like 8 chests. There was like 5 skulls. All different kinds. There was them, a bunch of barrels in the water, like the gunpowder kegs, but I couldn't get them because there was a storm rolling in. There was the trader village, this trader alliance, not trader village, trader alliance. This one here.
Hey hey hey.
Until hey hey
next
hey.
Time, Captain. Hey hey, it's Fat Albert.
So see, like you see how that over there? That's where the Reaper's chest is. It wasn't doing that, but it was at an outpost, and I found it. And I couldn't get the Reaper's chest, but I found ashen chests. I didn't find the key, but I cashed in every single bit of it. There were people that were super chill. I went fishing with this guy I'd never met, and we just got to like talking with like the little quick commands and stuff, and we went fishing, we played music, danced. We chilled. He didn't steal any of my stuff or whatever. We were just really chill. Said hi. Really nice and chill player. I really do value that in people. If you're chill, I'm chill. If you sink me, it's part of the game. I'm not gonna like it. Who likes being sunk? Nobody. Unless you're just kind of in that thing. But if you have stuff and you've prepared and you really just want to have fun with it and you don't mind getting sunk, then you're fine. But I also disarmed a ship, bought that another sloop because I can't captain one of these by myself, and do it efficiently. You know, it's supposed to be run by 4 man, actually about 6 would do. And so, like, I just didn't take it. I've done it before, but it's not too hard. It's just not really efficient to run a galleon by yourself. If you want to do that, just use a brig or a sloop if you want to go solo. But that was like the biggest, like, and luckiest find ever. That was such a big score, such a great win. But if you enjoyed the video, please don't be selfish or hesitant to smash the like button. Subscribe to my channel. Let me know what you thought. If you liked it, say good job. Just anything. Feedback is awesome. You enjoyed? Stick around, check out my other videos. I'll catch y'all in the next video. Take care. And goodbye. One more quick thing I wanted to add to this. So just luck was really with me as Davy Jones. He really was. Just like Davy Jones so far has been like my look of choice. He's been my look of luck. He's awesome, he looks so good, and he's brought me so much fortune with it. Just so canon, it just looks so perfect. The video, but there's one more important thing.
Join my crew.
I was a captain, supposed to be a captain of a large ship. If he has no crew to run it, I'll put my gamer tag in the description. So you can contact me if you want, we can be friends. I play on Xbox, you can add me, you can catch me in streams, request them, and I'll play with y'all whenever I get a chance. I don't do open crew, like I don't click it, I always do closed crew, and I'll add you in personally. If you feel like it, join my crew. If you want to sail with Captain of the Flying Dutchman, let's do it. Sea of Thieves awaits. Take care. And goodbye.